Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be jumping into DaVinci Resolve 17 and color grading SLOG footage from the Sony a7 III, which I'm filming on right now. So this video was requested by a subscriber, and I do take requests. So if you do have any tutorials or anything you want to see, drop it in the comment below and I'll try my best to do it. So let's quickly just go through SLOG and what it is. So basically all camera manufacturers, whether that's Sony, Canon or Panasonic, have what is called a log profile. A log profile is a gamma curve that they apply to the footage that you're filming, and it basically gives you a relatively flat image. The hope of this being that you're going to get more dynamic range, so more information between the shadows and the highlights. So that is what a log profile is. Now we're going to show you in DaVinci Resolve 17 how to color grade it the simple way, and also how to do it manually, or I guess the hard way, which isn't actually that hard, but I guess it's harder than the easy way. Before we do that though, we're gonna have to set our camera up first. So when filming in S-Log on your Sony, whether that's the a7 III, the S3 or the R, whichever one it is, you're gonna need to overexpose your footage. Generally, when you shoot in log, you do have to expose to the right, so overexposing, and that is so that you have enough detail in the shadows to recover, because having a flat profile over a sort of evenly exposed image is going to really crush those shadows and you're gonna lose a lot of information. So we have to overexpose. So that's where you're gonna wanna make sure that this little thingy here shows +2, and that's gonna be nice and easy. Once you've done that, you start filming, and we're gonna jump over to DaVinci Resolve 17 and show you how to make it look like proper footage. So opening DaVinci Resolve, here we have our footage that we've imported into the program. And as you can see, it's this nice, flat, relatively gray image. So to start color grading this and getting it to looking something a little bit better, we're gonna head over to our color tab. So heading over to the color tab, your screen will look something like this. You'll notice that the color grading screen, the tab here, will change depending on how, I guess, wide your screen is. Because I've got a relatively wide monitor, you're gonna notice that, yeah, you see a little bit more. Basically, what I want you to understand is that what we need to at least open is your node section. So up top right corner, nodes, open that up, and the rest we can sort of just leave as is. Awesome. So the real quick and easy way to do this and sort of like cheat, I guess, is to head on over to your LUTs up in the top left here, head on over to Sony or whatever camera you shot in log, and you're gonna grab basically one of these ones. And if you hover over it, you'll notice that it will change your image and you get a pretty okay representation of what it's going to look like. And then you can drag that on. Awesome. With that applied, you can see that straight away it is relatively good. To deactivate this color node, you can just use Command D or Control D if you're on Windows. It's gonna turn it off and on. You can sort of see what we've done here. And yeah, it's pretty close. If we were to open up our histogram, so you're going over to the bottom here, click this, and you can change it from histogram, parade, waveform, all this sort of stuff. I'm gonna go histogram here. You can see that it's relatively evenly exposed. There's no sort of huge spikes here. We could probably raise the gain just a little bit and maybe raise the gamma, which is gonna be roughly in the mid sections here. And the lift can kind of come back down a bit. And again, like pretty okay result, but that's just like the quick and dirty way if you wanna sort of get it over and done with. What we're gonna do, let's just get back to the start. So we're gonna delete this node, add a new one. So what we're going to do is the proper way. Okay, so when color correcting your footage, you want to keep it organized. So what I like to do with this first node is I'm gonna rename it. So node label, and I'm just gonna call this log footage. And I'm gonna leave it like that. I'm not gonna edit anything under this node. And then I'm gonna create a new serial node. You can do this by going color, nodes, add serial node, or you will see the shortcut there depending on what system you're on. Awesome. This node is going to be my conversion node. So I'm going to convert it from log color profile to Rec 709 or Rec 2020, depending on what sort of color space you're working in. Just a quick breakdown, 709 is sort of like standard dynamic range and Rec 2020 is high dynamic range. So we're gonna rename this one and gonna call this color space, because that's what we're gonna do. To do this, you're gonna go to your open effects, and you can go down to Resolve Effects Color, Color Space Transformer, drag it down over your footage onto that node there. And then you've got a couple of different options here. So input color space. So the input color space that we're using is Rec 709. The input gamma is SLOG, okay? So actually SLOG 2 in this case. The gamma being the curve that was applied to the footage. So we're gonna go down here, we're gonna scroll down to Sony SLOG 2, and you'll notice that the footage changes there. Output color space, we're gonna change to Rec 709. Now, of course, you would change this depending on what you're in. And the output gamma, we want it to output at Rec 709 as well, okay? So we want it to be at, you know, our normal color space. We don't want a curve applied. And pretty much that's all we need in terms of that one. So you can see now, if I was to turn this color space node on, basically it's raised a lot of, it's deflattened this image and made it pretty well evenly exposed. And that's because we exposed it pretty well to begin with. The next one we're gonna do is create a new node, and I'm going to go node label, and I'm just gonna call this saturation, okay? And this is where I'm just gonna add saturation to the image, because that's all that's left to do after we've changed, converted the color space. So under the saturation node, we're gonna make sure we've got our primary wheels open. Down the bottom here, saturation, we're just gonna boost that until it starts to look pretty good. And there you go, that is literally all it takes to get that footage into the right color space. And you can see if we deactivate it, that's what we started with, and that's what we ended with. If we were to turn the color space off, you can see it's still relatively flat, and then that brings it back into the right space. So there you go, guys. That's how you create a, take a flat image like this and convert it so that it is actually something, you know, easy to look at. Once you've done this, this is your color correction. Now you can do like a color grade, which would be your last one, and I'd just create a new serial node under this one, node label, and we can call this the grade. And this is where you would add a, you know, like a style or a LUT to the image. So we can go to motion VFX. We've got blockbuster here, and we can just add a bunch to it here. Just drag it on, and then we could decrease under this one here, we can decrease that effect there, 0.5. And now we have our grade. Very subtle effect there. We can have it at 100% if we wanted to. And even then at 100, it's not too bad. So there you go, guys. It's pretty simple. You can use the default ones inbuilt with DaVinci Resolve, and they generally do a pretty good job. Or you can do it manually depending on your situation, totally up to you. I personally don't really film in log all that much because it takes a lot longer to edit. And I find that like the dynamic range isn't good enough to warrant all that extra time, right? Like it's good, just not good enough to warrant all that extra time, especially with the content I film. But if you enjoyed the video, guys, make sure you hit the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more content like this one. And yeah, I guess I'll see you guys in the next video.